community participation. My ministry will continue to encourage more rural community participation in the tourism industry through community-based ecotourism, or in short, CBED, which focuses on community activity while stressing on the preservation of the environment and natural resources and highlight local cultural practices and at the same time providing jobs opportunities and alternative source of income. In 2017, an additional of 6 new homestays were registered. There were homestay Rumah Pengulu Philip Kayak, Sungai Daun, Sungai Durin in Cebu, homestay Lubang Batu in Serian, homestay Singai in Bau, homestay Mulu in Miri, homestay Longbanga in Ulu Baram, Miri, and Rumah Margarita in Julau. There are now 41 registered homestays with 582 operators throughout Sarawak. My ministry has worked with local communities through tourism awareness program to raise the awareness of tourism industry. The program is to highlight the benefits that can be realized from the dynamic sector, from this dynamic sector in improving the level of income and providing employment. My ministry has also carried out capacity building program for homestay operators and community through the courses such as Bengkel Pembangunan Produk Pelancongan dan Kursus Asas Perakaunan dan Keusahawanan bagi peserta homestay dan Bengkel Kebudayaan dan Kesenian. The objective of these courses is to increase the knowledge and service quality of the homestays operator so that they can provide excellent services to tourists and thus to generate more income to their homestay. In addition, my ministry also supports the homestays and local community by assisting them to coordinate the tourism activities such as the Gawai Open House, Hari Raya Aidilfitri packages, and Makan Tahun, which is celebrated by the Kedayan community. Tuan Speaker, events and festivals. Events and festivals has always been a pull factor to both domestic and foreign tourists, and at the same time providing business opportunities to the locals. The 20th edition of the Rainforest World Music Festival, or RWMF, was held at the Sarawak Cultural Village from 14th to the 16th of July 2017. The Ministry and Sarawak Tourism Board took a different approach to promote and add value to the 20th edition of RWMF by organizing what we call the Rainforest Fringe Event, or RFF, 1 week prior to the main festival. In the past series, the festival was only confined to Sarawak Cultural Village, and many felt that Kuching City or Kuching Nights did not feel the heat and the beat of this music festival. Our ultimate aim was to engage and bring Kuching Nights to have a feel and be part of the whole festival. The Rainforest Fringe Festival was launched on the 7th of July 2017, held at the auditorium of Sarawak Tourism Complex. The 10 days festival continued with several highly attended and popular events, among others, or namely, the Theatre of Clothes, which is a fashion gala, held at the Waterfront Hotel, Sada Kamek, Music of Sarawak, concert held at the Kuching Amphitheatre on July the 9th, Craft and Vintage Market, a two-day spread of local creative craft held at the Sarawak Tourism Complex compound. Throughout the weekend and over the next 7 days of that fringe event, exhibition, film screening and talks were attended by both local and international visitors until it's closed on July the 16th of 2017. The 2 days craft market of the festival, with some vendors reporting sales of more than 20,000 ringgit. Two special group of guests from Singapore and Kuala Lumpur under the campaign name Kuching Express were invited to attend the festival. Social media recorded 35,454 Facebook, 1,089 Instagram and 79 Twitters post up the Fringe Festival, gathered 104,533 likes, 1,119 comments, and 106,448 interactions, reaching to 1,739,132 individuals. This year, RWMF managed to achieve a record of 19,382 attendees as compared to 18,300 attendees last year. Out of this total, 30% were non-Malaysian. The value of ticket sales also increased by 30% from the previous year, bringing a total receipt of 959,885 ringgit. Most activities and varieties were also added to make the festival more vibrant and attractive. Apart from the music concert and nights, the festival has featured many other activities to keep audience entertained throughout the day at the venue. Among others, yoga, tai chi, zumba, silat and capoeira, a martial art capoeira demonstration was done. The festival also brought together collaboration with other government agencies such as Sarawak Biodiversity Centre, Sarawak Museum and Sarawak Energy to organise other fringe activities at the venue as value added to the festival. The RWMF has attracted 180 international media and 50 bloggers from around the world, which has garnered around 5 million ringgit worth of media value. Apart from the entrance ticket sales totaling, which was mentioned just now, 959,000, the total direct revenue received from the sales of handicraft was 100,000, while from food and beverages was recorded at 181,000. The overall festival was a success, and the results from the survey conducted testified that 84% of the audience were satisfied as compared to 78% the previous year.